All right, welcome back to the Cutler Report. Nanny Michael Bloomberg. That's what it is. Nanny Michael Bloomberg strikes again in New York City. He just made the Big Apple the first city in America to outlaw the sale of super-sized sugary drinks. Take a listen to Nanny Mayor Michael Bloomberg's response.
This is the single biggest step any city, I think, has ever taken to curb obesity, but certainly not the last step that lots of cities are going to take. And we believe that it will help save lives.
All right. Is this a necessary measure to fight obesity, or is this just government gone way too far? Let's ask our guest, Jeff Steyer. He's a senior fellow at the National Center for Public Policy Research. Jeff, last time you were here, Bloomberg banned, let me get this right, kosher food for homeless people.
All food donations to homeless shelters in New York City.
All right. So now he's banning large sugary drinks. Wait, except if you go to 7-Eleven.
Well, you can go to convenience stores, but you can't go to restaurants. You can't get them in movie theaters. This has nothing to do with obesity. This is the nanny state gone wild. And it's not just New York City. It's the Centers for Disease Control funding these types of efforts for soda taxes, for bans on smoking in outdoor places, for bans on e-cigarettes, which help people quit smoking. The nanny state has been co-opted by big government activists. It's no longer about public health anymore. The public health community doesn't exist. This is actually bad for public health.
Who is the nanny state Politburo in New York City? It's just like the old Soviet Politburo. This thing was going to win because it had all Bloomberg's appointees on it.
Yeah.
Who's running this Politburo?
Well, Mayor Bloomberg and his people, Dr. Farley, the head of the health department.
Czar Bloomberg. Right.
Yeah. Well, Mayor Bloomberg's health commissioner, original health commissioner, is now running the Centers for Disease Control, Dr. Tom Frieden. So it's not just New York City. The whole federal government is now funding efforts like Mayor Bloomberg's efforts to demonize soda. This will do nothing to curb
obesity. Do we have any free choice, any personal, individual liberty, free choice when it comes to our food left in
this
country?
If this is justified, if this move made sense, then we may as well ban large hamburgers, large French fries. There's no science behind it. There's no justification for it. It's all about the government taking more control over our lives. And it's not going to curb obesity.
Regarding obesity, you know, someone once told me if you eat less and you take nice long walks
on a daily basis,
you might lose 10 or 15 pounds. What about that idea? And you can do it on your own without the Politburo czars looking over your shoulder.
Well, that's what I'm saying. The public health community has been co-opted by big government types who think, you know, the government has to solve our problems. And you're right, obviously, personal responsibility, personal freedom, choice. Free markets should come help solve problems.
Oh, my God, free markets. That is it. Jeff Steyer, you have just said the word. Up next time.